Chad Law, Inner Circle Radio. I'm in the Stolen Goods layer right now, counting down the 50 most quality controlled albums of 2013. I assembled a really good brain trust with me to help break down our top 10. My number 10 spot is gonna have to go to Excuse My French by French Montana.
Ain't worried about none. Nigga ain't worried about none. Nigga ain't worried.
So French Montana being number 10, Excuse My French, and has a shitload of singles that I feel like a lot of people are still bumping to this day. And as far as a full-length album, I think our brain trust is going to break that down as to why that's a number 10. It might even have to be a little lower than that. Who knows?
French Montana has to leave the fucking paint. Like, there's no way French Montana can be on this list. I'd rather listen to the sound of French dressing put on salad than French Montana. There's 5-6 other albums that I can name off the top of my head. I could be high, drunk, and I can get shot right now and think about things, and my life could be in danger before I put on French Montana. No French Montana for you. But if he's number 10, then you know what? The thing about it is he has listening power as far as radio stations are concerned. He has singles that you'd be like, oh, this song is cool. But when you hear the entirety of his work and things of that nature, then nah, French Montana got to lead the band. And that's just my take.
Our number 9 spot is going to go to Troy Ave and the New York City album, which is an actual full-length LP release from Troy Ave, the first that he got in his discography. He just dropped White Christmas 2. He's got Bricks in My Backpack, Volume 1 through 3, Bricks in My Backpack with all his BSB boys, multiple volumes of them, but this is the first time that Troy Ave dropped an actual full-length album.
Bridge!
Now, the number 9 spot, do I think he deserves to be there? That's pretty fair. He's worked. He's been grinding his ass off, so I salute Troy Ave in the grind.
I definitely agree that he definitely deserves on the list. Compared to who else is on the list, he might go a little higher. That's how I feel. Especially as a person who didn't listen to anything before, and just the New York album being the first thing I've heard from, I was pleasantly surprised. I think it's better than the new project. I think it's better than the new project coming out or that's out. He has bangers on it. He got hits. He got radio ready hits. At this point, it's just up to the fans. It's up to New York to support him. That's basically how I feel about that. He's definitely a strong contender for number 1 or any other spot higher than number 9.
Our number 8, we've got ASAP Rocky with Long Live ASAP. I said it must be. Now this one, on the other hand, came out in January 2013, ASAP Rocky's first debut album. I don't exactly know if this is the one that I think is going to have the staying power, but we'll see what the brain trust has to say.
It was a cool album. I mean, it was cool. It was very diverse. You know, I like the diversity and everything that he did with everything, but the only thing that I didn't like about it is the content of it. Like, I felt he didn't... Like, you know, what he was rapping about was like the same few things, but as far as sound wise and like the type of hooks and, you know, stuff like that, like he had the stuff for the pop, the fist pumping people, and then he had the fucking problems where he's switching his flows and everything up. But top 10, I'll give it that.
So do you guys think that he should be number 7 or should he be lower, since the first 3 people that we've named on this list are New York artists?
ASAP should definitely be number 9, only off the strength that as far as like telling a story, when I listen to these projects, I'm looking for an actual story. ASAP didn't tell a story.
Not in there.
He just did tracks.
Troy Ave should move up.
Agreed.
I think Troy Ave should move up, definitely.
Definitely agree.
I'll give you a hug.
Alright.
So,
with that said,
yeah, everybody's agreeing to move Troy Ave up.
That's it.
Yeah, I mean, if I'm outvoted, I'm not gonna argue if I'm outvoted. You know,
yeah, I'll
Troy
vote.
Ave rap better. Yeah, I just, you know, the diversity of everybody
it
else
was a
I like better.
Album.
Yeah. Troy
Ave? And Troy Ave, and one thing I'll say about Troy Ave. Troy Ave is one of the few rappers that we have that stay on topic.
Thank you.
Right. That is true.
Exactly.
Everything.
He stays on topic.
That counts
for something.
It does count for something, especially it's not that hard to stay on topic when you're talking
really
about your life. When you're talking about something you actually done, it's very easy to get off topic when you're just talking about something you've seen done or something you aspire to do.
Right. So now we're at our number 7 spot. And right now I'm at a confusion, man, because I don't know who should really be at this spot. Me personally, I'm putting Beyonce here. The females at home, they might rip my head off for this, but Beyonce is gonna have to get the number 7 slot on this list for this Beyonce project.
I think we didn't say the best hip-hop album. This is the Quality Control, right? Right. The album was quality. It was controlled quality. Therefore, it should be on the list. We're discussing the culture here, and she's definitely relevant to the culture. The only other thing, the only excuse we would have to say to not put her on the list would say she's just a higher echelon of music. So I definitely think she deserved to be higher than number seven. Here's way higher.
Hove and Beyonce both had albums that made sure people, they reminded people that they're still human. Exactly. Like they're vulnerable, you know? Exactly. Like Hove wasn't talking about crack the whole time. Beyonce was talking about regular people shit, you know?
Exactly. Yeah.
So right now on our list, we've got number 10, French Montana, Excuse My French. Number 9, we've got ASAP Rocky, Long Live ASAP. Number 8, we've got Troy Ave, New York City, the album. Number 7, we've got Beyonce with the self-titled album. Our number 6 spot is going to J. Cole, Born Sinner.
As far as Born Sinner is concerned, it was a dope album, or a dope collection of music. I personally think J. Cole did his thing. And he told a solid story.
Some J. Cole beats to me kind of put me straight to sleep. But he can rap his ass off. Everybody knows that. Like, you know.
Money.
Yes. Along with Truly Yours too. If we're counting that, then it was a pretty solid body of work. Also, I'm definitely moving that up.
Exactly, that's my thing.
I'm definitely moving
that. That was my only thing. That was my only thing about what you said earlier was you might move him up depending on who else.
I already know what's next.
You know what I mean? It's at the end of the day, you know, if an album's strong, it doesn't matter who's ahead, who's behind. It doesn't matter. It's going to be top five whether Jay is in it. If it's top five, it's going to be top five. You know what I'm saying? It shouldn't be contingent upon who it is. I definitely think J. Cole deserves higher than top five. He definitely deserved to be in that. No, I may be fronting. He definitely deserved to be top five. Solid top five. Solid production. Solid storytelling. I wasn't bored with the album. I might have skipped maybe one song, but you know, Born Sinner along with the Truly Yours projects, can't go wrong.
Number five is gonna have to go to Mac Wiles, the New York Love Story album. First off, for the people who didn't hear it, it's basically like an R&B album, but on classic New York like hip hop beats. So nobody does that. I can't even imagine the money that he paid for clearance. I'm not saying it wasn't fire.
As far as the sampling goes, I feel like he loses originality using so many samples, only because J. Cole, like Reek says, did the whole thing by himself.
So work,
production, writing. So it just makes him more creative.
Every one of those songs.
So then work.
And so the Brain Trust has decided that J. Cole Born Sinner is moving up to number 5. And now Mac Wiles, unfortunately, homie, you're going to have to drop down to number 6 on our countdown.
With your Grammy nomination.
But it's all right, though. Hope you win that Grammy nomination, man. Now on our number 4 spot. My Name Is My Name, Pusha T, the debut album of the Good Music Clips Crooner, and man, this is a damn good album that I think might have to actually move itself up.
Man, there's no way in hell y'all gonna tell me My Name Is My Name is the number 4 album. Why not? Numero uno. Numere uno. Whatever. Fuck my Spanish. Number 1. No way in hell. He dead. He went across. He was trying to do no radio friendly hits or whatever.
There's no wax songs on the album at all. Okay. That's probably one of the songs. That's probably one of the only songs of the top 10 with no.
We're gonna get there though. I think we should have a vote on this. Like that. Who thinks we gotta get to my name should get moved up?
Definitely.
Absolutely. Well, we all agree with that.
I think it should get moved up.
I think before we even move it up, we need to get to the last three. So
let's do it.
Yeah. Of course. So right, number 3 spot. We're gonna take our attention to Nipsey Hussle and his $100 mixtape Crenshaw.
Shit changed, now it's such a different game. All the niggas like myself is controlling everything.
Yeah. Nipsey Hussle's project.
You go out. If you paid $100 for that, get out of here.
Open the door.
Open the door. We need a door for you to get out of here. All right. You paid $100 for that.
Yo, Crenshaw was a dope project, but $100?
My body now.
If Moses came to me, call himself MC Moses. I wouldn't pay.
This spit bars? It spit bars?
What if he was spitting though?
What if he gave you the Ten Commandments and Kendrick's flow?
Then I ask him for 5 minutes outside. Because he just sold his raps. Manu Ginobili, son. Like, wow, you know Manu Ginobili can get 40. But he just gets 15. But you get scared of 15 because it might turn to 40. But it's like, damn,
you,
it's over.
You got to close out.
I think you had 15
And it's a quiet 15. Saying,
what he wants to do, he can get 40.
And look, it's a quiet 15. It's not even a 15 where you're like, yo, he dunked on three. It's a better. Like, he got all those at the line. He got all those at the line.
It's a 15 with no rebounds,
no assists. All at the line. All at the line.
He's rap game manager, no.
So with our revised list, at number 10, we've still got French Montana, excuse my friend. Number 9, we've got ASAP Rocky, Long Live ASAP. Number 8, we've got Troy Ave of New York City, the album. Number 7, we've got Nipsey Hussle, Crenshaw. Number 6, we've got Mac Wiles, New York City. Number 5, we've got Beyonce. Number 4, J. Cole, Born Sinner. And number 3, Pusha T, made that move up. And now we're hopping into our top 2. With number 2, we got Drake. Nothing was the same. Motherfucker never loved us.
Remember? Great, start with me, because I really dislike her. I mean him. Whatever. We're calling Drake at this point.
Shots.
Honestly, if we talk about Drake, she's strong. She's a strong artist. She deserves every little bit of artistic accolade she gets. But if we're talking about
ladies, we're talking about Nothing Was the Same.
Nothing Was the Same is probably going to be, and I hate saying this, it's probably the only album on this list that is in its right.
Not that he's that you're referencing Drake as a female throughout your entire argument.
He has not slipped up.
That's concentration right there. Kudos. Kudos.
No.
Number 10, French Montana, excuse my French. Number 9, ASAP Rocky, Long Live ASAP. Number 8, Troy Ave, New York City, the album. Number 7, Nipsey Hussle, Crenshaw. Number 6, Mac Wiles, New York Love Story. Number 5, we've got Beyonce. Number 4, we've got J. Cole, Born Sinner. Number 3, we've got Pusha T, My Name Is My Name. Number 2, Drake, Nothing Was the Same. And now number 1.
Number 1.
One.
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 One. Ho, Magnum Carta. Blue told me remind you niggas.
Fuck that shit y'all talking about. I'm the nigga. Let me explain why this guy should not be number 1. First of all, I listen to every single Jay-Z album, including Unfinished Business and Best of Both Worlds, and this is his most hollow, transparent album that he's ever put out.
Blasphemer.
A lot of the album was fire beats and not fire content. That's one. Two, there's more skippable songs on here than probably Kingdom Come.
I can pretty much just go ahead and say that I am a full-on Ho stan. So me choosing Magna Carta as number 1 fit pretty much accurately, because from top to bottom, I didn't skip anything off Magna Carta.
Not a song.
And I'm just going to
my Chad Law Mac Vick. Listen,
for real. That was Quality Control Albums 2018. Chad Law, Circle Radio, the Black Eye Stuff.com.
We done?
No, you need more of these. Psycho bitches in my lobby. In the paper photo shoots with paparazzi, can't even take my daughter for a walk. See him by the corner store.